core strengthening exercise. Some poses you may find are similar to yoga, but breathing technique is going to be a little bit different. So in Pilates, the breathing is in the nose and out through the mouth. There's a nice deep breath in.
Then you fill up your lungs instead of the belly.
And you're going to push the breath out through the mouth. Great. So it's not a belly breath like it is in yoga. It's more of a chest breath. So you're going to breathe in on the lungs. Push it right down. So in Pilates, we inhale to prepare for the exercise, and we exhale to execute the exercise. So how about we get started? Okay, so I want you to find a seated position, whatever is comfortable for you. Then I want you to lengthen through the spine. Imagine somebody has this string right here. They pull it all the way up. They lengthen you all the way through the spine. I want you to pull the belly button in toward the spine, and then maybe lift it. A little bit up underneath your ribs. By doing that, you are going to engage your entire powerhouse, and we want to keep it like that for the end of the class. We'll make sure our shoulders stay down away from our ears, even when we go out with our arms, the shoulders will stay down. Let's find that deep breath then. So take a deep breath in the nose, push it out through the mouth. Again, a deep breath in. A little hard with this. We're going to inhale all the way up, draw the shoulders down away from the ears. Then as you exhale, you're going to push those arms away, activating every muscle in the arms. And let's do that again. Inhale all the way up to the top, draw the shoulders all the way down away from the ears, and then exhale. Great. We're going to inhale all the way up, draw the shoulders all the way down to the back. Let's stay right here for a moment. Okay, take another deep breath in. And as you release the breath, I just want you to hinge forward slightly, the long spine, better to be forward, just hinge. You're going to take another deep breath in. And as you release the breath, you're going to lift all the way up to the top. We're going to take a deep breath again. And then on our exhale, we're just going to drop over to the side. Great. Ooh, inhale through the nose. And then exhale through the mouth. Inhale through the nose, return to the top. And then exhale through the mouth. Push all the way down, away from the ears, shoulders all the way down the back. Great job. We are going to take ourselves down onto your mat. Great. Always keep the core activated. We're just going to pull ourselves all the way down right here. Awesome. So we want to walk the heels in toward the rear end right here. We got it. And then pull the belly button in. I'm just going to scoop that belly. We're reaching our fingertips toward the heels. Good. So I want to lengthen through the arms, lengthen through the spine, keep the core activated. So we're going to take a deep breath in as you inhale, you're going to lengthen. And on your exhale, you're going to tuck your chin, and you're going to roll up to your belly button. Then you're going to take another deep breath in. And then as you release the breath, you're going to roll yourself back down. Nice, slow, big control. So let's do that again. Inhale, exhale. You take a deep breath at the top. As we release the breath, we are coming back down into that same position along the spine, activating core. One more time. Inhale. Exhale. Take another deep breath in. As you release the breath, you are going to roll yourself back down and return back here and stay activated through the core. Awesome. From here, we'll extend the arms all the way up. Then we'll put the palms facing down toward the toes. Arms are activated. Pull the shoulder down away from the ears. We're going to take that deep breath in, and as you release the breath, you're going to push down, all the way down to the floor, activating every muscle in those arms. We're going to inhale at the bottom, and we're going to exhale, bring it back up. Great. So take a deep breath in, and as you release the breath, you're going to push all the way down toward the heels. Now inhale, lift. So we're going to go a little bit different here, and then exhale down. Activate that core, keep it activated all the way up here. And then all the way down. Fantastic job. Bring it all the way up right here. Good. We're going to bring the arm palms facing in. Awesome. We're going to take a deep breath. And as we release the breath, this time we're going to extend the arms out to the side. Great. Now another deep breath in. And then you release, you bring it to the center. Good. Make sure that belly button staying toward the floor. Take it out to the side. And bring it back in. All right, so we're going to change the breathing a little bit. So it's inhale, back to the top of the shoulder right here. Palms facing down again, the shoulder down with the ears. So we add on. When we take the arms down, we're going to roll ourselves up a little bit. So we're rotating our head, we'll lengthen to the spine. Then as you release the breath, you're going to tuck the chin. Then you're going to bring this up. Great. Then we inhale back up. Exhale, tuck and roll. Inhale, rich bird. And exhale. We're going to do that one more time. Bring it all the way up. And this time we're going to take ourselves down. We're going to hold right here. Great. So we're taking a deep breath in. And we let the breath out. So we're holding this position. Right. Now I just want you to do a little pulsing in this position as you breathe in through the nose deep. You should be able to hear yourself breathing out. Great. Now hold in this position. Great. And then we're going to move through to our starting position. Let's take our hand down by our side right here. Reach your fingertips toward the heels again. We're going to bring our legs up to tabletop position. We want the calves right here parallel to the floor. And we want our knees directly over our hips. Reaching our fingertips now so the arms are also activated. And then here, we're just going to take those toes and we're going to tap to the floor and bring it back up. So we don't want to necessarily bend the knee. We want that knee to remain constant. We're using our hip. So we tap and we lift up. Great, do it on the other side. We tap. Remember this. So we take a deep breath. And as you release the breath, you're activating right here. You're executing that. Awesome. The other side. You inhale as you lift that leg up, and then you exhale, you tap the other toes down. Inhale, lift it up, keep that core engaged, and exhale. Great, let's do both legs at the same time. Take a deep breath in. As you release the breath, you lower down as far as you can with that lower blood, that lower back. Come on the floor, then you breathe it back up. So it's a deep breath. On the exhale, you're executing the exercise. On the inhale, you're returning. Arms are still activated. Great, one more time. Also bring it back up and hold right here. Right, so we're going to tuck our chin in. We're going to roll ourselves up. We're staring at our belly button. Reaching the arms all the way out. If you do yoga, you might know this right here. We're going to do our 100s. So we're looking toward our belly button. At any time you want to drop the head down, you can. At any time you need to put the legs down, you can. Arms are out. And we're going to start pumping the arms right here. Ooh, and you're breathing in. And out. Great. So we are in our position. We're just going to change our breathing pattern a little bit here. So we're going to do 5 short breaths in and 5 short breaths out. So it's in. In. Out. Keep going. Keep going. Also, keep breathing into the nose. Open the mouth as you pump those arms. Keep the shoulders down. Keep the core activated. Great job. One more time in. And then we're going to release on the last exhale. We got that. Amazing. Reach your fingertips toward the heels one more time. Let's do a little bit of bridge work now. So your fingertips are still staying down by your side. And we're just going to take a deep breath in. And as we release the breath, we're going to roll our hips up one vertebrae at a time. And just walk your shoulder down toward your heels. Good. We want to put the weight into our heels right here, squeezing that butt. And we're going to inhale and exhale. Slowly roll ourselves down one vertebrae at a time. At the end of your exhale, you should be all the way back down to the floor. So we take a deep breath in, we release, and we lift all the way up. Inhale. And exhale back down. Great, you again. Take a deep breath. As you release the breath, you roll up. You take another breath at the top. Then as you release the breath, you roll back down. Great, we're going to take ourselves up. We're going to hold in our bridge. Continue to breathe into the nose and out with the mouth. Great, from here, we're just going to extend one leg all the way up to the ceiling in between the toes. Great, so inhale and exhale. Great. Now we're just going to lower the leg and we're going to lift it up. Great. We lower. Inhale to lift back to the top. Exhale, lower down. Ooh, inhale, lift it up. Great. fantastic job. So let's do that on the other side. We're going to lift the opposite leg up. We come up into the bridge. Great. We come down for just a moment. Come all the way up. Great. So we're taking a little bit of hold right here. We're going to lower the leg. Your cheekbones hips up. We lift. Great. We lower. We inhale to lift it back up. Then we exhale to lower down. Inhale, lift. And exhale. Great job, on it, guys. Great. Awesome. Let's do it one more time. Take a deep breath here at the top. On the release, when you release the breath, bring yourself back down. Both feet back on the floor. Great. Let's just bring our legs up to the tabletop position for a moment and just roll side to side. Awesome. So we'll place the feet back down on the floor. We're going to continue to do some leg work. This time the legs won't come out. I don't want to We're going to extend one leg all the way up to the top. The opposite leg can be bent, or you can take it down long. If you take it down long, I still want it to be activated with the foot flexed. Here or here. I'm going to elect to bring it in. So my top leg turns a corner, keep the core engaged, pull the belly button into the spine, shoulders push down into the floor. We're going to take a deep breath. As we release the breath, I'm going to take the leg out to the side, and we're going to swing it around. So it's inhale at the top, and then exhale. Inhale, exhale. Inhale, and exhale. One more, inhale, and exhale. Great, we're going to reverse the direction of the circle, so we're going to take it over the body a little bit. So if your leg is bent, you may not be able to take it quite as far over. If your leg is long and you're taking it over, we don't want to come off that hip. We want to make sure both hips stay on the floor. So we go inhale and exhale, circle. Inhale. Great. One more time. Pull right here. Awesome job. We're bringing the knee in. Put the foot on the floor. Bring the opposite foot in. All right, so we're going to do the same thing on the opposite leg. Remember, so this leg can be bent or it can be long, whichever you prefer. Our shoulders cut into the floor. We lift the leg up. We're going to take the leg away from our body. So we take a deep breath. As we release the breath, we take it away and we circle it around. Inhale through the nose, exhale through the mouth. Activate the core. Inhale and exhale. Belly button's in and lifting it up. One more time. Hold right here. Great, so we're going to take it over the body. Leg can be long or bent. Inhale, exhale. So all hip work right here. Scoop it up, belly, and keep that core activated. And we're going to do it one more time. Great, and then bring that foot back here. Not going to reach the floor. That's not so bad, right? How's everybody doing? Great. You're ready to really get moving now. We're going to come sideways. In our side position, we're going to start out. What I want you to do is check to make sure that you're in a long body. So your heels, ankles, knees, hips, and shoulders should be all in a straight line. Your elbow either underneath your shoulder here, or you can come down in this position. If you're in this position, I still need you to keep your torso off the floor. And another option is to have your head resting into your elbow here. Again, we still want to keep our torso off the floor. So find whatever position is right for your upper body. Core is activated. We have a long spine right here. Ooh, we are going to take our legs and bring it into about 45 degrees. Right, your hand can stay on your hip. Or you can bring it in the front here to give you some more extra balance, extra help on the balance. So we're going to lift up our top leg, and we're just going to flex the foot to the front, and then we're going to point the foot to the back. We flex it to the front. Now let's add breathing. So we're going to inhale forward, and exhale back. Try not to drop back and forth with the upper body. The upper body stays right where it is. The movement is right here. Let's add a little pulse in the front. So it's pulse, pulse, release. Great. Inhale, pulse, pulse. Exhale back. Good. long spine. Core is activated. One more time. Take it to the back. Great. And we return to center. Now I'm going to bring your legs back to that long position. Again, hands can be here. Try not to lean forward into the floor. We want to keep ourselves up nice and tall. Long spine, activated core. The top leg, we're just going to lift up. You lift up and lower down. You lift up. Great. We're going to inhale. Now, slow control. Lift. And we lower. We lift. Lower. Get your core activated. Now, pick that leg up and hold here at the top. Inhale. And exhale. Now I just want you to draw little circles on the wall using your toes and you breathe into the nose and out through the mouth. Can you reverse the direction of the circle? Sure you can. Great. Continue to breathe into the nose and out through the mouth. I want you to draw a figure eight for me. Oh, that's so easy. I'm going to challenge you a little bit. Reverse figure eight. Ah, inhale and exhale. I have to think about that a little bit. Great. Now extend the legs all the way down and just bring it to the floor. Great. We're still keeping everything activated. So we're going to do a little thing called, what I like to call, is pulling the socks on. So we're still up nice and tall. We're just going to bring our toes to knee, extend the arms up, and come down. So imagine you're just pulling your socks on with your toes. Let's inhale and exhale. Great. Inhale and exhale. Awesome. Keep it all the way down right here. We are actually going to roll our sets down. We're going to take our socks off. But it's going to look like this. So you're going to lift the leg up. You're going to bring the heel with the toes to the knee. And then you're going to push your back. Ready? Let's go. Inhale. Inhale. Inhale.
in, exhale. Great. Extend the arms all the way out. So we're going to try this again. When you do rotate, and this time though, try not to let that arm float to the front, okay? You want to make sure the body stays in a T position. Knees can be bent if you need them to be. Shoulders are down, core's activated, spine is long. You take a deep breath and you lengthen. As you exhale, you just rotate through the torso. You inhale, come back to center. And exhale, rotate through the torso. Inhale. Back to center and just drop the hand down. That's not so bad. We're going to open the legs just a little bit. You can shake them out. Another option is to make sure that you can keep the knees bent. But we're going to do the same thing. This time we're going to add a little chip. Okay, so we're going to take pinky to pinky. Shoulders are down. We take a deep breath in and then we release. We take another breath in and then we take it down. We inhale it. Exhale back to center. Take a deep breath in. And then release the breath into rotation. Inhale. Exhale. Pinky to pinky. Inhale up. And exhale back to center again. Inhale. Job. Let's take this to the other side right here. So we're going to do this on the other side now. Remember, we start out checking our body for alignment. Ankles, knees, hips, shoulders, all in one line. Elbow directly underneath the shoulder, unless you need to jump here or here. Even though you do that, we still want the torso lifted away from the floor to keep our core activated. Here, shoulders are down. We're going to bring our legs to 45 degrees. And then we're just going to lift the top leg. It can be here or here. We don't want to lean forward. And we're going to flex forward. We're going to point back. We're going to flex forward. Point back. We add up for breathing. So it's inhale, exhale. Try not to roll. Inhale. And exhale. Great. Pulse it two. Take it back. Two pulses to the front. Inhale, two pulses. Exhale, kick back. Inhale, two pulses. Exhale, kick back. We return to center and we bring our legs right here. Great. So let's just lift the legs up. So we'll lift and lower. We lift and lower. Great. Shoulder down and back. Awesome. Great. We're activating this way, squeezing through the thighs. Awesome job. Take the foot up and hold with the toes. Little circle on the wall as you breathe into the nose and out from the mouth. Continue that breath as you reverse the circle. Great. Maybe figure eight as you continue breathing in and out. Let's try that reverse figure eight. Awesome job. We'll bring that leg back down. Remember the socks on and socks off? Let's do that. We're going to pull on first. So we take a deep breath. We pull in. Great. One more time. Great. Now let's reverse it. So we're going to take it up. Shoot the knee. Push away. Another breath out. Breathe in. little stretch right here. We're going to inhale all the way up to the top. On the exhale, we're going to take the hand behind the bent knee. We're going to lift all the way up in a little rotation. You're going to take a deep breath and release the breath. We come back down. Inhale. And exhale. Inhale. And exhale. Great job. So let's take it over to the other side. Once the knee comes in. This knee can be bent if you need to be. Inhale all the way up to the top, pull the shoulder down. On the exhale breath, you're going to tilt forward, drop the head down, tilt forward the knee. We'll lengthen the spine as you drop the shoulder down, away from the ears. Great. Inhale and exhale. Maybe on an exhale breath, you can find as you come a little deeper into the stretch. Breathe in. Out. Another breath in. And as you release your breath, pull yourself all the way up, shoulder all the way down. We're going to inhale all the way up. So we're going to take the hand behind the bent knee and move it all the way up as we inhale. Take a deep breath. Release. Right. Inhale. Inhale. Awesome job. Both legs long. Knees bent if needed. I'm going to keep mine bent for just a moment. Shoulders all the way down or still activated. Inhale all the way up to the top. Now on the exhale, I want you to go long spine. Another deep breath. Now on the exhale, I want you to go ahead and fold. Allow your hands to fall wherever is comfortable for you. They don't have to be on the feet. Draw the shoulder down away from the ears. You're just looking down toward the knees. If your knees are bent and you want a deeper stretch, maybe walk the hips back one at a time to help lengthen the legs. Take a deep breath in, and maybe on your exhale breath, you can find you can go deeper into the stretch. Another breath, and release, and come back up. I want you to find a comfortable seated position, whatever's right for you. I'm gonna cross my legs, you don't have to. We're sitting up nice and tall, but of course still activated, correct? Yes. Let's inhale all the way up to the top. On our exhale, we're going to tip over to one side. We're going to inhale back up to the top. And then on our exhale, we're going to take it over to the other side. We inhale back to the top. Bring your hands together and bring them down to the heart. Shoulders down, another deep breath in. Beautiful job, everybody. Thank you for joining me today. If you have any questions or comments about this class, please do reach out to your home health wellness team. I hope to see you again soon.